get ready to match the stars. Jack Carter, Fred Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Barbara Bowes, Bill Daly, and Dear Abby, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of the match game, Gene Reddard.
You forgot your purse, dear.
I thought you'd never bring it.
It really doesn't go with my outfit.
If that's all the mail she gets.
That's not her mail, that's her purse. Now, why didn't you want to carry that out?
Well, it's a little off color. It doesn't quite go with
me. Yes, it does. Now, stand up. Now, stand up here. Now, that goes.
It's beautiful.
I think it's an ensemble. Look at that. All right. Let's say hello to Charlotte Laughlin and Desiree Gill over here. Let's get reacquainted, shall we? Tell us a little bit about yourself again, the short version, Desiree.
Okay, I start with my son, and then there's my daughter, and she's 12 years behind him.
Right. And you're from?
I'm from St. Thomas, Virgin Islands.
Okay, nice to have you with us. And Charlotte? Your kids, you got three kids out there?
My mother.
Oh, your mother.
She's a kid.
She's a kid at heart. That's nice.
We just recently moved to Moberly, Missouri. We were purchasing a farm. My husband and I are both high school teachers, and he works full-time as a music director in a church.
Oh. If you're going to live on a farm, you're not going to farm the farm. You're going to continue teaching, huh?
We're going to do both.
Oh, you are? You're going to be one busy lady. All right. This is round two. The score is tied. Desiree went first last time, so Charlotte will ask you to go first this time.
A.
A? Okay. Jan said, it's strange being married to a laboratory scientist. At our wedding, instead of rice, his family threw blank. Laboratory. A laboratory scientist. Got two smart ladies.
He needs some coffee from anybody, but he can't see that far. Poor spell. Well, that goes nuts.
Coffee for me.
All right, here we go. Jan said it's strange being married to a laboratory scientist. At our wedding, instead of rice, his family threw
test tubes.
Okay, anything. The object here is anything you'd find in a laboratory. Test tubes, beakers, Bunsen burners, all that stuff. I don't know what took us all on.
Yeah.
What's wrong?
Wait, look at him. That's my favorite word, laboratory. And in a laboratory, you throw test tubes. Okay.
Yes?
Now listen to this. This is going to be a match, and I don't want trouble from the judges. Now pay attention, Ira. Specimen jars.
Right.
You talked him into that?
Sure.
You talked him into that?
It's so fabulous because Desiree is so lovely. And Brett's middle name on the birth certificate was Desiree, except they made one small mistake in the...
spelling?
In the spelling in Portland, and or Maine.
What was that, Charles?
It came out Miseray.
Blood clot.
Blood clot. Blood clot.
Thank you.
Oh, dear. Okay, Barbara. Married to a laboratory scientist at our wedding, instead of rice, his family threw...
I like to do this the way it should be done. I don't like to cause any problems. Test two.
Test two. Okay. Three for Charlotte. What do you got there for the lady?
Specimens. Sorry.
Specimens.
New group. Only specimens.
Right. A rock group called the Specimens.
Certainly help you dress better.
Four specimens.
Okay. Abby.
Specimens.
Okay.
I thought that was brilliant, Abby.
I did too.
Yeah, you're smart.
You stole it from me.
Okay, you ready, Desiree?
Let's go.
Now you need three to tie, four to win. Fat Frida's husband said, you've all heard of the man of a thousand faces? Well, my wife is a woman of a thousand blanks. Oh, you go right for it, don't you? That's right, you know. One more time for you? All right, I'll do it for you. Fat Frida's husband said. You've all heard of the man of a thousand faces. Well, my wife is the woman of a thousand blanks.
Inches.
Inches.
That's a good thing.
A thousand inches.
That wasn't bad.
That's interesting.
Charlotte just sighed. Huge relief. I don't think she has confidence in that answer.
I don't think she has either. What do you say,
Jack? She was so fat she needed a bookmark to find her chin.
So that she's a woman of a thousand...
1,000 pounds.
1,000 pounds. She'd have lots of chin. What have you got there?
She was so fat she was a woman of 1,000 bulges.
1,000 bulges.
Good, right?
Those are my people out there.
Right. A woman of 1,000 places.
Oh, really? All right, now you got to match a bottom tier, Desiree, to stay in the game and achieve a tie. Barbara?
Well, I'm glad I played well the last time. 1,000 chins.
Yeah! Chins. That means Charlotte wins the game. What did you have over there, Dylan? I had a chin. I'm going to spin you off. We'll come back and play the second game later, all right? Now we'll do a little business with America. Here we go. Now, Charlotte's going to have a go at the super match here, where she can win a great deal of money. Let's see how she does. We polled a studio audience, Charlotte, not too long ago, and said, write down your best answer to this. You're my blank. If you give us the answer that that audience wrote down most often, you get $500. Then if you give us the second most popular answer, $250. If you get the third one, you match that one, you get $100. Now look into the eyes of the stars and see which ones have a glimmer of intelligence. Call only on those. The others ain't got no answers.
Has to be Dear Abby.
What have you got?
You're my everything.
You're my everything. There's one.
Charles.
Charles.
The song from,
Forget it. I'm not helping you this time.
Oh, Misery, come on. The song from Jerry Herman's musical, Aunt Jan to Annie Mae. You're My Girl.
You're My Girl, okay.
A popular favorite.
All right.
Brett.
Yes, sir, you're my baby. No, sir.
She should do an album.
Listen, the singing is not bad. The lyrics are all screwed up, though. It's good. Yes, sir, that's my baby.
That's right.
You're my
baby. Well, but you're my baby's nice.
Okay, you're my baby. Fine. That's a phrase. You're my baby. You're my girl. You're my everything. Those are the three they gave you, Charlotte. You can give us one of those. Choose one or give us one of your own.
Let's go with You're My Baby.
Really?
No. Oh, don't pay any attention to them, Charlotte. You never can tell.
I'll say. Okay, she says, You're My Baby is what she wants. We'll find out if it's up there right now, beginning the $100 response. You're my sunshine. Well, they got that wrong, too, because it's You Are My Sunshine. Yes, right.
It's got to be you.
Yeah.
All right, let's take a look at the $250 number. You're my Valentine. That's a good one.
Be my... Oh, please, dear Lord, let it be.
You think he's going to be there, audience?
You'll be there.
No. All right, now, wait a minute. What do you think it's going to be? Everything. They're saying everything. All right, slide the big one. Everything.
You haven't got anything here.
You can have another game, though. All right, so let's bring Desiree right back, and we'll play the second and final game. Here we go. Okay. Well, here we go again, Desiree. Are you ready?
Waiting to go.
All right, you can have A or B.
I'll go with B this time.
All right.
Desiree B.
Jim said, there's too much violence in the world today. I just saw 3 fist fights, 2 car wrecks, and a mugging, and that was inside the local blank.
Put it in there.
All right, Desiree. Jim said there's too much violence in the world today. I just saw 3 fist fights, 2 car wrecks, and a mugging, and that was inside the local blank.
Bar. It's got to be in there.
In the bar?
Yep.
I don't know. We were going for something, someplace where there would be unlikely to be fighting, and bars are places where they do fight.
Right. True. She's got it wrong. As Father Flanagan said, don't fight in me church.
Church. Wow. Okay. Good answer, church.
Captain?
Yeah.
Church. Police station.
Police station, not a good one.
The thief.
Station and hello, Angie, of 82nd Street, 20th Precinct, New York. Police, keep up the good work.
We are looking for places where they'd be unlikely to have fights there. Now, Barbara, what'd you say?
I said the church.
Church is a good response.
Good for
police
you.
Station, all over the good. Bill?
Churchville.
Abby?
The police station.
Police station and the church came up most frequently there. All right, now let's see how Charlotte does with her first round question. Sarcastic Sam said, this new pen will write underwater. It'll be very useful if I ever have to write a check to blank. Sarcastic Sam said, this new pen will write underwater. It'll be very useful if I ever have to... All right. It'll be very useful if I ever have to write a check to blank.
Charlie Tuna.
A very good answer, I
Indeed,
think.
Yeah.
Don't you think that's good, Jack?
That's not a bad idea. I know that Jaws doesn't have a bank account, so I figured Jacques Cousteau.
Okay, Jacques Cousteau's a good one. He spends a lot of time underwater.
Well, I figure they had direct delivery to Moby Dick because he had an apartment down there.
Moby Dick, another good one.
Well, Gene, you know, I work for the Coast Guard Auxiliary, and I make training films for them, my gang. And I do a lot of wonderful things on my own boat. So I said, of course, our beloved leader, Jacques Cousteau, for rental, and this is laying a bomb, I can feel it already, for driving equipment. I'm not going
to go. Okay. She says, Charlie Tuna, a good response.
I thought it was a great response.
But there were some other good ones, too.
Thank you. I said Jacques Cousteau.
Jacques Cousteau is very good. He's seen his stuff. He's always underwater.
Charlie was good, though.
Hello, Bill.
Lloyd Bridges.
Another good one.
Too old.
The lady with the white collar.
Mine's very original. Write a check to Neptune.
Neptune. You thought that up by yourself.
I certainly did.
Yes.
No, the nurse helped her write it. I saw that.
Oh, the nurse helped. Okay, so there we're at in round one. No score here, but we're going to play another round anyway, in spite of everything. Hurry back. Let's carry on here. Go to round two. The score is tied. Desiree went first last time. So, Charlotte, you go first this time.
Let's go with B.
Okay. In Washington, D.C.,
right.
George said, I think the economy is in really bad shape. Today I saw President Carter standing in front of the White House selling blank. Having
God,
a difficult
baby,
time.
It's all finished. It's in
Things
the
Things are in bad shape in the economy. I saw President Carter standing in front of the White House selling blank.
Don't he sold Herbert Burt Lance. We'd all be in one.
Now, don't look at that.
I'm finished.
So many ways to go.
You're telling me you're finished?
Well, try one.
He did.
This lady molesting you?
She told him.
And then the guy balled me out because
who balled you out? You're a star.
Balled
him out?
She balled me out. Somebody balled me. They said
that's what you can't. But he's a star. Don't you talk to Bill Jader.
Don't you let them ball you out?
Run.
Nobody balls me out. Who
don't you
out?
Let them molest you that way?
Yeah.
Ah. He's recently married.
Nice. So okay, am I. Sure. So it works
so
out all right.
That's all right. Two cheaters are better than one.
In Washington, D.C., George said, I think the economy is in really bad shape. Today I saw President Carter standing in front of the White House selling...
Pencils.
Pencils. You associate pencils with President Carter, eh?
Nowadays.
I see. Nowadays, she said.
Usually we
don't be surprised.
Right. Yeah, I agree. Yes.
Incidentally, Jimmy and I are not related.
You're not?
No, I don't even know what he changed his name from. But he already sold Amy.
Yeah.
So now he's out there selling teeth and toothpaste.
Teeth and toothpaste. From the White House. Okay. Here we go.
In 1981, he's going to change it to something else. Okay, Charlotte, let them boo, let them carry on, let them behave badly. Pencil. We care not for public opinion, my my darling.
What do you got there, Chuck?
I got an on-time answer. What do they call it?
Timely.
No, on team and
oh,
team.
Oh, on team.
Intimate. It's intimate, you idiot.
Leave him alone. I am conducting this colloquy. You shut up or your mouth when I'm talking to him.
My answer is very au courant.
Au courant. That means in the swim.
All these words are hard to say because of my dental work. Selling cabinets.
That's going to be a very significant answer when this show is rerun in 1983. They're going to love it.
Kiss my Schlesinger.
Okay, Barbara.
Well, I thought the president would sell something he could get a good return on. I thought he'd sell peanuts.
Peanuts! Wasn't that a brilliant answer?
She's not only beautiful, but she's bright. She's nuts.
Right. Okay. All right, Abby.
I'm with the beautiful one. Carter would be selling peanuts.
Peanuts. Okay. So, Charlotte, you picked up one there. Now, Daisy Ray, here it is. You need one to tie.
We've been playing here for 9 years, and we have one point up.
That's right.
Since 1937. We're doing real well. They're
not very lucky, are they? Gloria said, today, my boyfriend decided to tie the knot. Unfortunately, he tied it around my blank. There you go. Read it again. Finished?
There you are, my darling.
Charles, all right. Gloria said, today my boyfriend decided to tie the knot. Unfortunately, he tied it around my blank. But I'm jumping. Bum, bum.
Actually, it was a good one.
Come on.
Hey. Gloria said, today my boyfriend decided to tie the knot. Unfortunately, he tied it around my...
I hope it was her legs.
Okay, let's see what we got over here from Jack Cotta.
He did want her to hang around, so he tied it around her neck.
Her neck.
God knows I can.
Did you think of neck? Why didn't you say neck? Was that,
that was my first answer.
Ah, I see. We say trust your first response here, and she didn't pay attention. What have you got for her?
Oh, she did something that really steamed him, and he tied it right around her throat.
Throat or neck would seem to be the answer here. Okay.
You know, you talk just like an MC in a three-piece suit. Neck.
Two pieces. No waistcoat today. All right, Desiree, let's go down to the lower tier and see if we get a pair of legs here anywhere.
I think she would have made a killing with neck.
Yeah. That's four necks so far.
I was thinking legs, but I put neck.
All right. Hey, you must match Abby to achieve a tie.
I was thinking neck, so I put neck.
All right, Charlotte. Congratulations to you. Right there, a little blue down. Desiree, we're going to send many gifts your way. Thank you for being here on Match Game. Desiree Gill, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to spin her off there now.
Okay.
And spin a commercial. All right. How are you?
Oh, I'm fine.
How's Vivian?
Oh, she's wonderful. Vivian who? Oh, sorry.
Vivian is your new wife, that sweet lady who loves you so, and she's so beautiful.
Thank you.
Okay, give him some advice about how to stay married here, Vivian. What would you like?
First of all, get your hand off my leg.
No, wait, no.
Is she beautiful? She's so great looking.
What is
if I was going to mess around, I'd mess around her. If she'd allow me to mess around.
All right.
I've been trying. No, she's good looking. Good.
What is this, a small boy?
No, I just... What is the secret of longevity in a marriage?
How should I know? I've only been married for 40 years.
Oh, well, then you
What's
wouldn't
the secret?
Know.
Yeah, no, she wouldn't know.
There's no secret.
There is no secret.
No.
You just have to do your own thing?
You do his thing.
Oh, I do his thing. Okay. You see, you lost
the same thing. I'm Gene Rayburn, and I hope you'll join us next time for Match Game. Goodbye.
Today's consolation prizes are Beacon Thermal Blanket. Lets you warm up the natural way with a blanket for all seasons. 100% cotton, easy care from Beacon Thermal Blanket. And beautiful bath faucets and polished satin chrome with natural onyx inserts from Kohler's Alterna Collection. Built-in quality, dependable velvet system, Kohler faucets, a tradition of quality and craftsmanship. And a tea kettle, and a supply of cup of noodles. Enjoy it anywhere, anytime. Ready to eat in just 3 minutes, right in his own cup. So good, fast, and easy cup of noodles. And handle with care for Samir. Discover the first fine fabric wash that safely cleans and has a built-in fabric softener. Handle with care for total care. And delicious pork products, roasts and ribs, steaks and chops, tender, loving fare from the National Pork Producers. A new Ovaltine hot cocoa mix in a canister set. The extra rich, extra chocolatey cocoa that has 7 added vitamins and minerals in every cup. Available in reduced calorie, too. A Niagara Spray Starch, the store body that detergents wash away for faster ironing. America's favorite spray starch is Niagara. Broadcast.